In the name of my ancestors, peace forever and always. Welcome to another edition of the Realities Temple on Earth. I am the host of this internet ministry, the gatekeeper of this channel. I am known on YouTube as the Mighty, Angel Snuffing Up 7, your brother, and hopefully your friend, Talik Ibn Rum. And if you don't want to be my friend, why the hell are you hanging around on my channel? If you are not my friend, why are you in my business? Why the hell do you care about what Angel Snuffing Up 7 is doing? I don't understand that. Because if I'm not interested in you, I damn sure not going to hang around you. But you have those who say they don't like you, but they know more about your business than you do. I don't get it. You don't like somebody, but always in their business. Always got to say, you always have something to say about them. But that's all right. I am glad that I have earned enough of your mindset that I'm worthy of coming from my name. I'm tongue-tied. Excuse me. I'm worthy of my name coming forth from your raggedy-ass mouth. With that said, I would like to dedicate this video to one of my strongest supporters, one of my strongest critics, a critic and a supporter, and I appreciate that because I know his critique comes from a good place. And he wants me strong. And he wants confidence that I, who he will support, is worthy of such. And that shout out goes to my brother, Kizmac. Kizmac, you know who you are. Also, I'd like to shout out to my brother, David Brayboy. And my sister, YS to God, and of course my assistant administrator who will soon be back on the scene, brother Andre Edmonds 69. And really, I just like to send a shout out to all of you new subscribers, old subscribers, old friends, new friends. Thank you for coming to this house. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to give what I have to say a listen. And I hope that you judge what I have to say as worthy of being listened to. I wish to make this video as a platform for all those with questions as far as my asking your help to take this ministry beyond YouTube and really out in the streets. The time has come that we must become active. And if we are not active, we might as well shut up, because if the word is not producing activity, the whole thing is pointless. And I refuse to be pointless. I refuse to be the center of entertainment for some people, because I don't view black struggle, liberation, I don't view civil rights as entertainment. This is serious business. It affects us, those of us who live today, and it affects our children that will come into this tomorrow. If our parents had worked a little harder and been more active as a majority, our situation would not be as critical as it is today. But that was them. So if we criticize them and what older people have done, it was not enough. Now it is your turn. What you gonna do? Continue to run your mouth and be entertained by your beautiful words? Or are you gonna take your beautiful words and put them on a spindle and turn straw into gold? And that's what I want to do with this ministry. Take this straw, take this rawness, take this nothing, and feed the multitudes. Take this straw and make gold. But I can't do it by myself. I already know this. I need your help. So I want to spend a few minutes with us, and you can always bring your comments or your questions to the more information section, the comment section of this video, and we can speak about things more in detail. I don't care who you are. All questions, all inquiry will be accepted. I'm not going to block nobody. You want to try to prove that I'm a con man, a criminal, and all? Bring your ass on, baby. Bring it. Because I got something for you. You can't handle the real truth. We already know this. But you want to attack my character. You want to assassinate me, my person. Well, I'm going to show you the same way that you fear the opinions and the ideas of this ministry. You're going to fear, and you're going to bow down and submit and back down to your falsehood, your accusations of my person. You're going to lose whether you go through the front door or you come through the back door. It makes no difference. You're not going to get nothing off here. Nothing. So shoot your best shot. And when I embarrass you, don't remove your comment. Let people see how ignorant you are. Because I have already, the majority of these folks, I have already beaten the hell out of them with real truth. They can't handle this. So their only option is to attempt to paint the messenger as evil or corrupt or a con man, whatever these names they want to come up with, because they see success. They see glory. They wish they could talk the way I talk. They wish they could look the way I look. They wish they was me. But it was not meant for you. The real truth was given to me, because you, for some reason, the creation found unworthy. And by your behavior, I can see why you were unworthy. So those with these hood rat channels come before the people any kind of way. Dressed all tacky, you look like a criminal. You look like a thug. Who the hell listening to you? You look like a gangster. You look like trash. Do you know why I come before the people with a suit and tie? I want to show you that I'm silver. I want to show the masses that they are worthy of me putting on a suit. You are worthy of me looking clean for you. When a man is dating a woman, if he has any kind of sense, he wants to look his best. So you mean to tell me on all these hood rat channels, that's your best? You want to try to represent people? Is that what you want, brothers and sisters? These hood rats to represent you? Then when they talk a good game. I'm not going to never say that there are not words of wisdom that come from the ghetto, from these hood rat channels. But you don't want that to represent you when you talk to President Obama or the President of China. I'm looking at this in an international scope. When you go meet the governor of Missouri or the governor of West Virginia, would you want these hood rats to represent you? Plus, they'll never get there anyway, unless they are a rapper or something like that, an entertainer. But to speak serious business the way I talk, you got to show them you have some kind of sense, that you are not a savage and you're civil. Speak with intelligence. Use the English language in the best manner that you can. To show the world, I'm just as civil. I'm just as intelligent. I'm just as great, if not better, than you. So a man dresses up the best way he can because he's trying to impress the woman that he loves. You don't love me enough to put on a suit. You don't love me enough to put on some clean clothes to talk to me. But you have women that will lay down with these ragged ass men, and they ignore the one that has some sense. Then they wonder why they are in the sad condition that they are in. The man told you what he was about. He couldn't even put clean clothes on for you. He can't bring you flowers, give you candy. He won't open up the door. He is not a gentleman. He wants to be this thug thing, this savage creature, and you accept that, and you get what you pay for. I'm here, and I put on a suit for you because I love you. I want to put on my best impression that I can. Now, if my best impression is not good enough, there's nothing I can do. But I want to show you that you are worthy of me putting on some clean clothes. I want to show you that I love you. I love humanity, period. But I'm a black man, and I have lived among black people, and we are in a bad condition. So my first priority, when you're looking at the sick, is the one who is the sickest, the one who is in the most bad shape. So my number one priority must be the black people, those of us who are born the descendants of slaves in America. But all of the human family needs to be treated because we're sick. If we were not sick, there would be no need for Jesus Christ. If we were sick, there would be no need for Prophet Muhammad or any of these religious belief systems, because God sent prophets to the people not because you are well, but because you are sick. You are filled with some kind of disease. And now the time has arrived and the period of time has arrived that now you be healed. It is now time for the return of Jesus Christ. It is time for the fulfillment of the words of Prophet Muhammad. You're living in it right now, if you understand. So I have these critics, of whom I easily, in a debate, they can't talk, so they can't debate. They can barely write. I'm not going to make mockery of their education, because for me, I only have a high school education. But you take what was given to you and do the best that you can with it. and then whatever you have, try to make it better. These people, these hood rat channels, make no attempt to make themselves better. They think that for some reason the world is supposed to accept them in their ghetto fashion garbage. Well, I'm sorry. There's nobody in the world that likes living in the ghetto. You should want to get out of the ghetto or transform the ghetto to make it better for the people. Because there's nothing wrong with the ghetto. It's the mentality of the people, and the building can always be torn down and rebuilt. And the ghetto can look just as clean, just as beautiful as any other place on the planet. But the problem is the mentality of those who live in the ghetto. So you have these ghetto channels that want to critique and talk about me. They offer nothing of substance except the usual ghetto-ness. They have no idea how to strive and reach for better stars. So they are jealous because they know that this ministry has the potential to grow beyond our wildest dreams. They will be just designated to YouTube, and pretty soon, and probably sooner or later, they will close their accounts. They will even stop talking because they have nothing to really talk about. Your mind is limited. The mind is limited. While here, I represent a train of thought because it is self-thinking and because it is connected to the universe, and the universe is limitless, then this word will always be growing, always be evolving. It's limitless. They are earthbound while we're building rocket ships to take ourselves out of the earth's gravitational pull. So you bring your ghetto-ness here and continue to get your ass whooped. You can't do nothing with me. Your best bet, if you don't like me, keep my name out your mouth. Go about your business. Because you can't stop nothing. Why are you running your mouth? My subscribers steady climb up. Why are you running your mouth? My friends steady climb up. Why are you running your mouth? Donations are coming in. We're going to talk about that. So you can't do nothing. It's jealousy. They want to be Talik Ibn Ra. But Talik Ibn Ra didn't just come out the sky overnight. What you hear from this ministry took 40-some years to come into existence. If you knew my mother or my father, you would look at me, look at them, and you would wonder, how in the hell, how did you come from out of them? My parents were sharecroppers. My parents was drunkards. My parents was fornicators and adulterers. That's what my parents was. My parents was sinners. They didn't know no better. It was a lifestyle. So how could I come from out of them? Because it's time. When you pray, the reality, if you want your prayers answered, is always going to be by a man. Those of you who believe in God, God does answer prayers. But remember, God uses men. You want to be free. You have a problem. Whatever your problem is, God's going to bring it, the answer, through a man. And men come from women. So every time we suggest to a woman to abort her child, you are erasing a possibility that that baby could have answered your prayer. That's the problem. When you ask a woman or women allow themselves to have abortions, you are cutting off your lifeline to the creation. That's how the creation talks to you. That's how the creation gives you your gifts. Through the womb of a woman, because all things come through a womb. The universe is a dark womb. And the woman is a symbol of the womb. They are a womb, and the womb communicates and brings about.
So fine, so fine, blow my mind. Ooh, so fine, so fine, blow my mind.
Do cocaine. I do not do cocaine. No. I do not do cocaine. I don't do cocaine. But these people pay me to advertise, so I'm going to advertise because they pay to advertise. Now, if y'all do good cocaine, don't say Sniffy taught you to do cocaine. Because I don't do cocaine. No. That ain't the reason why I sniff. Now, there's some of y'all that like methamphetamine. Okay? Alright? So go get your bag of methamphetamine. Okay? That'll help you. Whatever your problem is, get you a bag of methamphetamine.
Catch us live at the gym in 101.5 R&B Fees.
November 6th at Magnus Arena.
Get your tickets now at gympresents.com. We'll see you soon. Now, what was that you were saying earlier, T?
What I was saying was, what you do?
What you do?
Where you at?
Where you at?
Oh, you got plans?
Oh, you got plans?
Don't say that.
Shut your trap.
Unless you hear.
Unless you hear.
At the spot.
At the spot.
We got a show.
We got a show.
It's going to be hot.
It's going to be hot.
If you feel the way we feel and you want to come party tonight, baby, tell us that you're coming through.
We gon' leave the door open.
We gon' leave the door open.
We gon' leave the door open, y'all.
We gon' leave the door open, open.
Y'all coming?
Come on through.
Come on, y'all. We wanna see you.
It's going down tonight, y'all.
y'all.
Hey!
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Happy holidays.
Happy New Year that's coming.
Invoke t-shirts.
Yay!
Woo-hoo. We have other styles, too, so make sure you check out our website.
Definitely. Bye. Happy holidays.
Happy
holidays. We wish you a Merry Christmas, baby.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, baby.
And such happiness in the coming year.
Happiness in the coming year.
Happy holidays, everybody.
Answers through Ingram via the woman. And it is the male's responsibility to keep the communication lines open by protecting that telephone system, which we know of as the woman. Defend her at all costs. Because if you don't, then you are cut off from the wisdom of the universe. Because whatever you're going to get is going to come through that woman. So you have to take care of her. You got to make sure that her mind is right. She's treated. You can't keep her mind filled with foolishness, stupidity, because that's messing up the lines of communication. That's that distortion, crackling. So instead of getting, when the baby is born, instead of getting a clear message from the Creator, you get another fool. You get another idiot. Now sometimes, like I said, sometimes even through distortion, if you knew my mother and my father, it's just mind-boggling. How did these people produce you? Because sometimes God or the creation take things in his or her hands and takes the power away from them, and he begins to mold that baby, that child, the way he or she. God is a he or she, or it. I just say that which brought us into existence. But it takes over and it forms the child, because the child is being born for a specific duty, and the time is right. The time has arrived. Either the human family will be free or it will be destroyed. You have had thousands and thousands of years to straighten your act up. This is judgment day. Like I said for this channel, either you're going to live or you're going to die. For me, if it was up to me, within the next 30 seconds, all of humanity, black, white, red, whatever, y'all be dead if it was up to me personally. So you better be glad it's out of my hand. All of humanity needs to be destroyed as far as I'm concerned, because we have not lived up to being worthy of living. Murderers, rapists, pedophiles, and the good people sit around talking about, I don't deserve to die. I good. Good for nothing, because you won't fight the wicked. Like Martin Luther King said, the reason why evil exists, because good people do nothing. And you're good for nothing. You don't want to take action. You want to go to church and hear pretty words, and the pastor said this, and the pastor said that. But you don't want to take action on it. Because the people in the church are already saved. But you got millions, millions upon millions that are not saved. That's where your ass needs to be. The healthy don't need a doctor. It's the sick. But maybe that's because you sick too. So y'all with these ghetto channels and these ghetto Negro thoughts, the way a parent should whoop a child. But I doubt if you will show up. And if you do, you will remove your comments. But the people already know when you show up, they're going to be looking at you. They say, oh man, this dude, this fool stupid enough to come on Talik's channel so they can get their ass whooped. I already beat these folks up long time ago. But you know how it is when you're dealing with some people, you know, you just have to keep kicking their ass. They don't never learn. Okay. So let us deal with some of the questions that have arisen that I would like to address. First question, what is your purpose? The primary purpose of this ministry is to free the human being from slavery, racism, religious dogma, gender bias. The human being, I did not say black. And black is a white racist word, really. But for the time being, that's the only way we can identify with those with dark skin born the descendants of slaves in America. We are not black. That's a white racist word. And African is too, whether you like it or not. So I'm not black and I'm not African either. Those were words created by the oppressor. And we are striving to move beyond oppression. So we must get rid of all slavery, all the forms, all the thoughts. And there are other things that affect other human beings that make them slaves. Gender bias, classism. The primary goal, the purpose of the Realities Temple is to cause self-thought in order to gain these goals. I want you to think for yourself. Think for yourself. Use common sense, reason, logic. Think for yourself. Stop depending on leaders. I ask you to join this ministry. Donate to this ministry. There is no leader. Compare this ministry to a beehive. There is no leader in the beehive. There's no one insect giving instruction to everybody. Everybody knows their place and purpose. For the time being, I am the queen bee. My purpose is to speak, and when I speak, that's laying eggs for the ministry to create helpers. But the helpers are not followers of the queen bee. They understand their purpose. And bee society is built around everybody knowing their place and doing their job. Because if so-and-so don't do their job, the whole colony dies. The queen bee is not treated no better than the rest, given what is due because of the purpose of being the queen. But the queen bee is not better than the rest of the hive. In fact, all the bees, listen up, this is beautiful. In fact, all the worker bees, all the helper bees are really queen bees. They just can't lay eggs. So they all are royalty. Do you understand? I am not better than you. I just have a different job than you do. But my job is no greater than your job. Your job is just as important as my job. Because if we fail, all of us die. So that's the type of family that I want here in this temple. That's equality. That's justice. That's freedom. That's family. That's love. And that's what I want here. It's not about black folks. Now, black people are the main priority at this time. We are the catalyst to get something started. And you have to grow. It takes a process. You are not born as an adult. You start off as a sperm and an egg. We are at the embryonic stage. But as we grow, this is meant for the whole human family. Because we all come from the same place. Now, some people want to brag, the original man is the Asiatic black man. And all other people come from us. That means that there's a responsibility. That means we are all family in some way or other. But because of racism, because of classism, because of a lot of factors, we don't view ourselves as a human family. Oh, that's them in China. That's them in India. That's them in Africa. We don't see ourselves as a human unit. That must be destroyed, that thinking. Because whatever affects the human being affects all of us. And racism, classism, gender bias, religious dogma, it has affected all of us. In fact, that's the type of mentality that caused this division. So my purpose is to bring all of humanity back to family. But the top priority at this time, because chances are I'll be dead and gone by the time the process really gets it going. But we are the beginning stages of this process to bring humanity back to being human and eventually raising ourselves to the point where we don't talk about being God. We become real God. We become truly connected to that which brought us into existence, if you understand. And that's why, while I'm here on this earth, I want to keep talking to you. Keep feeding your brain. Keep talking to you. Keep stimulating your brain cells. Self-thought. Not get you caught up. I believe this and I believe that. Get you caught up in a box. You need to grow. The universe is always moving. It's always growing, evolving. That's the way your mind has to be. Very important for the woman to keep her mind undammed. You got to keep that water flowing in her so she can pass on self-thoughts, self-creation to her womb so we can get the proper answer we're looking for from our creation, the creation, that which brought us into existence. Some of y'all may want to say God, but let us view God in a real sense, that God uses the womb of the woman. We must make accepting our reality the base of our thought. Reality. Just a few days ago, I watched my pet die in front of my eyes. That's my reality. My hope, my belief is that my pet goes to heaven. Goes somewhere in a place where when we pass, we will see one another again. A beautiful thought. And it's wonderful to have hope and faith. But that should be secondary. We should hold our reality as the primary base of our thought. Because if you lose reality, in psychiatry, they say you go insane. And that's what has happened to the human family. We have gone insane because we have made hope and faith and belief more important than dealing with our reality. And when that happens, you go insane. Who can join? I will be quite honest with you. At this time, only black people can join this ministry. And the reason for that is because black people need to learn how to do for themselves. They must learn their value. They must learn that they can really achieve and do whatever anybody else can do. They don't need nobody's help. They must build their own hotels, grow their own food, create their own media. They must be given a chance to do for themselves, to show that they are grown, just like anybody else. Black people should be tired. Well, if the white man didn't give you this, if the white man didn't do that for you, you wouldn't have it. We need to put ourselves in a position that the TV that you watch, that's ours. That the corn that you're eating, we grew it, that's ours. We need to do our own thing. We need to show that we are also adults, we are grown. But this is not to say that you cannot, other people cannot help. Because the reality is temple, my friends and subscribers are from all around the world, Asia, India, Africa, Australia, places in Europe, white people, red folks, all kinds of folks are the subscribers and friends of the Realities Temple because they understand where I'm coming from with this. You need to give it, it's just like a child, a parent and a child relationship. You need to give your child an opportunity to be grown. Let him take care of himself. Buy his own car, buy his own gas, get his own job so he can feel and be an adult. Black folks, the only thing we know of is living among white folks. Black folks, black, white people, however you want to say it. We have done nothing on our own without the help of white Americans. We need to be able to put ourselves in a position to show white America, Asian America, or whatever, we need to show to the world that we can also build, we can be technological, whatever anybody else can do, we can do, if not better. Not bragging, just we want to be able to have a chance to do what y'all have done. It's selfish to not allow a child to grow up. Some people spoil their children. They won't let them grow up. They keep, no matter how old they get, they keep letting, they want to do things for the child. Let your child grow up. Let these black people grow up. But sometimes these parents just want to stay in control of their children. They like to have control and authority over something. And see, that's the problem.
Take a look at what's going on, people. Thank you.